of Yahweh's footprints.
They don't bend their knees, spread their hands, and cry to God for their nation as we had done. You know, when he said, as we had done, I saw together with him the saints Moses, the saints Jeremiah, they all come and stand there. Now, all these saints were great intercessors who stood before God on behalf of their nation. The prophet Moses stood before Israel and he told the Lord, if you want to kill them, first you kill me. Right? Moses did that. And Elijah was a man who also stood before God and he turned a nation back from following idols to following the living God. And then you have Jeremiah, called the weeping prophet. In Jeremiah chapter 9, he says, oh, let my head be like fountains, and my head like waters, and my eyes like fountains, that I may weep for the perishing daughters of Jerusalem. So he says, they don't care, they don't pray for the nations as we have done. They are not like the elders in Jerusalem who sigh, mourn and cry for the sins of the land. In Ezekiel chapter 9 verse 4, you'll read about the elders in Jerusalem who sighed and mourned and wept for the sins of Jerusalem. You know, I was shaken with fear when I heard Elijah speak so furiously about these things. Let me repeat them one more time. Their churches are sleeping. They are self-centered. They don't care. Even those who are holding the lampstands, that I believe refers to ministers of God who have high status, high rank, or positions of authority. They don't care. Even such people don't care. They don't bend their knees. They don't spread their hands. They don't cry to God for their nation. They are not like the elders in Jerusalem who sigh, who mourn, who cry for the sins of the land. If this goes on like that, soon the flood will come to run over them. Now, shaken by all this, I ask, what should we do then? It is true that we are like this. It is true that we don't care. It is true that we don't have the burden. It is true. So what should we do? Is there anything that can be done to turn this whole thing around so that grace can triumph over, or mercy triumph over judgment? So when I said this out of a broken heart, I saw Abraham stand beside them and he said this: ask them to gather as many churches and leaders as they can, to fast and mourn for 3 days, to call for a national fast for their nation. When they do that, then the spirit of grace will be poured upon the nation. If not, then God will turn the nation over to judgment. Now, what will he turn the nation over to? Now please turn your Bibles with me to Romans chapter 1.